Hello and welcome to the 0th part of my LEGO Powered Up tutorial series that you can use to power up Control Plus and LEGO Boost. I decided to make a 0th part to explain all the stuff that we have in the Powered Up system and to explain the general purpose of the Powered Up system. But first of all, I make subtitles for this tutorial, so it's possible that you don't understand something because of my accent. Or maybe you're not sure if you understood something correctly, or maybe you just prefer subtitles in general. In that case, you can activate the subtitles. It's a normal YouTube function. There's an icon. You can click on that, and then you can read the subtitles in addition to the audio of this video. And this is more or less the hardware that's available in the powered up system. There's more stuff for Mindstorms, but it's not really supported for now, so I will stick to this stuff. And the stuff that's here, the normal powered up system, is meant to replace power functions. You probably know power functions. It was a system with another plug and infrared receivers. This system is based on Bluetooth. But now, let's start with the basic principle. For most of the stuff, we have motors and sensors. Some motors can contain sensors, but we will come to that later. Motors or sensors, they have this plug, and you can use this plug to connect them to the hub. These hubs have ports. They're labeled either as input and output or simply output. Maybe we will get simply input plugs in the future as well, but for now we have only two types. For normal hubs, the ports are input and output, but for battery boxes, the ports are only output. These ports are labeled so that you can address them, that you know which port you use or which device you want to use. And then we have these hubs, which are some kind of gateway between Bluetooth, so between the powered up remote and the sensor or the motor, or the smartphone and the sensor or the motor. You can also use the smartphone or the Android device or tablet or whatever to connect several hubs together, or to connect several hubs to the smartphone, to be more precise. And you can also connect this remote to the app and this hub to the app, and then let them interact and stuff like that. So there are many possibilities. And there are many apps for the system. We have the Redo 2.0 app, the Boost app, the Star Wars Boost app, the Powered Up app, and the Control Plus app. And all of these apps have different functionalities, but I will cover the Powered Up app because that's the overall system name, that's the overall app for the system, because the Powered Up app is compatible with almost everything on this desk. So the Powered Up app is the creative app where you can program your stuff, where you can change how your hardware behaves, and the Control Plus app is for remote control layouts, and the Boost apps are only for robots that use the Boost hardware, and the Redo 2.0 stuff is special. One note to the Powered Up app: it requires position rights because it uses Bluetooth Low Energy. That's a Bluetooth standard that uses low energy, and that's the reason why LEGO decided to use it. But the standard can, or allows the app to get the position of a smartphone under special circumstances. And that's the reason why the protocol requires position permissions. And that's why the Powered Up app requires position permissions. And we will cover the Powered Up app, which has a pretty simple way of programming, but there's also PyBricks, which allows you to program programs in Python and actually store them on the hub. That's a feature that will come to the Powered Up app as well, but for now you can use PyBricks to write programs on the hub, and then they are stored on this, and you can run them without a smartphone if they are stored on the hub. Basically what Mindstorm does, but with just one program. Anyways, let's start. And first we can talk about the remote. The remote can connect to some hubs directly or with the Powered Up app to other hubs that support the remote. And you can connect the remote directly to the Boost hub. I made a video on that, and to the Powered Up hub. simply press both of the buttons and normally they should connect. So that's a direct connection. You don't need something in between. And you can connect the remote via the powered up app to this app. This app doesn't work with the powered up app and it doesn't work with the remote. You can only use the Video 2.0 app to program this. So I will remove that from the table because that's not important for this video. There's a small disadvantage if you connect the powered up app directly to the Move Hub or to the powered up app, because almost all motors only have full speed or stop control. You can't control the speed of the stuff. You can control the speed of this motor, so each time you press on the plus, the motor will turn faster, and you can control the brightness of the LEDs in a similar way. So that was the remote. We have three things from the Video 2.0 system that lay here, and they are compatible with powered up. So you can connect this motor to the sub and then let the motor turn from the powered up app. And you can use these sensors. We have two sensors. The first one can detect the distance. So it can detect if something is very close or a bit more far away. It can't detect long distances, but it can detect if something is in front of it or not, and it can detect how far it is away on a small scale. Then we have the tilt sensor, which can discover if it's tilted, but it can only go from negative 45 degrees to 45 degrees, so you can't detect every tilt. And it has two axes, the X and the Y axis. You can use both of these sensors with all of the hubs, and this motor works with all of the hubs as well, but it only has on or off if you use it with the remote in a direct connection. You can program your own stuff or your own behavior if you use the powered up app in between, so there's no default behavior for that. Then we have the boost system, which comes with this hub. It has two integrated motors, one on port A and one on port B, and two additional input and output ports. It also has tilt sensors, so it can discover the position, and it has a LED with several colors. It has an on-off switch, and it takes six AAA batteries. The included motors of the sub have rotation sensors, so they can discover their position, but the position resets after each restart, so they're not good for servers where you want to drive to a certain position and where you want to know your default position, basically. So these motors don't have an absolute position. They don't keep the position if you turn the hub off, but they can detect the position. This motor can't detect the position, and the train motor that can't detect the position either. And that's the next motor. It's a simple motor that has no position sensors, and it works with all the hubs as well. So I don't think that we have to talk about that. Then we have the boost color and distance sensor. It comes with the Lego boost sets. And this is a pretty cool sensor because it has many features. It can discover the distance, but it's pretty limited, similar to that sensor. But it can also detect the color. There are certain colors that are built in the software, and you can detect them. And this can also be used to remote control power functions, infrared receivers. So you can send infrared signals with this sensor to these receivers, and you can let them move some motors or stuff like that. And I made a part for that, or I talked about that in more detail in the powered up programming tutorial. So make sure to check that out. I will link the playlist in the video description and in this video as well. So that's the current distance sensor. Is pretty cheap and very cool. And the boost set also comes with this motor. It's pretty similar to the included motors. So it has a rotation sensor, but it doesn't have an absolute position. And the rotation sensor of all these motors with rotation sensors can also detect the rotation speed. And there's a problem with some things, especially with this one, because the cable is very short and there are no official extension wires. So you are a bit limited in what you can build or on how you can build, because there are no official extension wires. I will make a video on unofficial stuff, but that will come in the future. And then we have the LEDs. They are simple lights or simple LED lights with a rectifier so that they work properly. And they work with all the hubs as well. You can't control each LED on its own, but you can control the brightness of both LEDs at the same time. And they work with all of these hubs, and they can be programmed in the Powered Up app. It's a bit sad because these Powered Up plugs can't be stacked on top of each other. So you can only plug one LED in one plug, and then you only have one more plug on this hub or one more plug on that hub. It's always a question if it's worth it to give up one plug for the LEDs, because you could also use a sensor instead. And this is the normal Powered Up hub that's used for city stuff and other system things like 18 Plus or Creator Expert and stuff like that. It has a multicolored LED as well and two ports. They're labeled A and B and are both input and output. And you can, or you need six AAA batteries in order to power the hub. That's the small hub or the city hub. And then we have the Control Plus hardware. We have this dumb battery box, which can power every motor or these lights, but only full power or full stop. It has two plugs, so you can use two devices on one battery box. And you can only drive in one direction or the other or stop the motor. You can't give a speed or you can't use the motor as a servo or stuff like that. Because you can use the motors that contain rotation sensors as servers, so you can use them for steering and stuff like that. Then we have the other Control Plus stuff. We have the Control Plus hub. It uses six AA batteries as well, same as this hub. The remote uses four AAA batteries, by the way. And this hub has a multicolored LED, position sensors, and it has four plugs that are input and output A, B, C, and D. So this is the hub. It comes for the Technic line of sets. And you can connect all these motors to the hub. This is an angular motor, so the output or the rotation comes with an angle from the actual motor form. And it has a position sensor. And it has an absolute position sensor, so you can use it as a servo. It can always return to the zero position. There's one slight issue. The Powered Up app doesn't support the zero position. So in the Powered Up app, this motor works exactly the same as this motor. So it won't keep the position, or it won't keep the position in mind if you restart it. But let's say that you use this motor for Mindstorms, then you can use the absolute position. And you can plug this motor and all of these motors into the city hub and into the Powered Up hub, and of course into the battery box. But you can't plug it into the boost hub, or at least not if you program the boost hub with the Powered Up app, because that doesn't work. These Technic motors at the moment don't work with this hub. And these come in different colors. This one is available in light blue as well, and this one is available in gray. And then we have these motors. They have the same features as these motors. So they have an absolute position, a normal position, and they can of course rotate. But they don't have a mark for their absolute position. That were the main Powered Up devices. They are all one system. The overall system is called Powered Up. So every device with this plug is called Powered Up. There are a few more things that use Powered Up in the background. because there's a powered up Bluetooth protocol that's used for the communication between the hub and the smartphone. And both the LEGO Duplo train hub and the Super Mario hub use the powered up Bluetooth low energy protocol, but they are not compatible with the powered up app. The protocol is released, I will link it in the video description, but it's only useful for advanced users. That was my overview over the powered up hardware. It has some advantages and some disadvantages. I think that the main disadvantages are that at the moment there are no official extension wires and there are no power functions, adapter cables. But it's great that now you can use sensors and the sensors are implemented properly. That's why we need a new plug, because this one has six wires in the plug and power functions only had four. So that way the hubs can detect if you have a sensor and which sensor, and they can interact with it properly that way. And this basically makes for some pretty cheap robotic sets. So these things, these simple hubs, come pretty close to what Mindstorms can do, especially with Pybricks, where you can download actual programs on the hub and store them there and then run them locally. But that was it for this video. Again, this is a playlist, or this is a complete series, so make sure to check the playlist out to learn how to program in the powered up app and how to get the complete power or the complete control over your hardware. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video, and bye!